Good evening, everyone. My name is Lidia Villarreal, and it is my honor to be here to be the master of ceremonies of this very special event. Thank you to each and every one of you for joining us for tonight's Nation's 43rd Annual Banquet, A Season of Gratitude. We have a very exciting agenda for tonight. So we're going to go ahead and get started. At this time, I would like to invite Pastor Gary Cox from First Christian Church for the invocation.
Let's pray. God, we gather tonight knowing that everything we celebrate is because of you. You are the one who writes the story and you allow us to participate. I thank you for how that story has included so many people through the years. We pray your blessings on each life that is in this room, each group that is represented, and on the nations and all that is accomplished. Above all, we pray that you receive all the honor and glory tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Pastor. The best way to remember someone who has passed away is to carry on their wishes, aspirations, dreams, and the spirit of that person. They live forever in our minds, in our hearts, and in our actions. And by doing this, we magnify the power of their love, and of course, we make this world a better place. So in memory of all those who are no longer with us, in their memory, in their honor, let's take a moment of silence. Thank you very much. Now we would like to acknowledge the following people who are joining us tonight. So as I call your name, if you could please stand up. First, let's start with our state and local officials. Fort Myers City Mayor, Kevin B. Anderson. Mr. Mayor. Lee Health Board Member, Therese Everly. Thank you for that applause to our officials. Now let's go ahead with our nation's board of directors, Dr. Israel Suarez, founder and CEO. Now Denise Fernandez. Here. Lee Ford. Paul Harris. Kevin Kyle. Katherine and Nina. Thank you for that applause to Nation's Board of Directors. Now let's go ahead with Nation's Board Advisors, starting with Diane Colon. Mario Juarez. Susan Ferris. Attorney Ryan Hamilton. Thank you to our Nation's Board Advisors, and now Nation's staff, starting with Ruth Suarez. Nice. Doris Rivera. Jose Carbona. Thank you for that applause to Nation's staff, and we have even more special guests that I would like to acknowledge. Who are here tonight, we have Dr. John Meyer, President of Hodges University. We have Dr. Michael Martin, President of Florida Gulf Coast University. And a Nation's 2006 Scholar, Janelis Ramos Perez. Perfect, thank you so much. Now we are very thankful and grateful for Nation's 2021 sponsors, GEM, because without their support, tonight wouldn't have been possible. So I'm gonna go ahead and recognize them as you see their names on the screen. Diamond sponsors. Honorable Bradford Sturgis. Shady Rest Foundation. Ruby sponsors. Sanibel Community Church. Emerald sponsor. Lee Health. Fort Myers Memorial Gardens. Sapphire sponsors. Florida Gulf Coast University. Amethyst sponsors. Lee County Sheriff's Office. City of Fort Myers Police. The Housing Authority of the City of Fort Myers. Great Florida Insurance. Carter Pritchett Advertising. Thomas Edison Congregational Church. The School District of Lee County. Topa sponsors. Chapel of Windmill Village. MB Financial Group. Appliances to Go USA. Synergy USA. Paul Harris Financial. Jasper sponsors. Hodges University. Canterbury School. The Dura Country Club. First Christian Church Fort Myers. Video by Lake Health Creative Services. Christ Centered Bookstore. BMO Harris Bank. Lee Health Gift Shop. The Good Samaritan Church. Rosa de Saron Dance Ministry. Rosado Pest Control. Felix Lawn Care. Media sponsors. The News Press. Noticia Swing. Way FM. Special thanks to Nation's event team and vendors. Diane Colon, Susan Bays, Catherine Mena, Karen Prater, Denise Fernandez and Doris Rivera, George and Patty Waters, Michael Shapiro Photography, Business Forms, Premier Style Studio by Sierra, Special Moments Event Service, Encore, and Luminary Hotel. So please join me giving them a huge round of applause to all of these years. Thank you very much. Now, as I was telling you at the beginning, we have a very exciting agenda for tonight. So I hope everyone is ready for some dance and for some music. We have an exciting performance by Rosa de Saron Dance Ministry to the song Thank You For It All by Marvin Sapp. The dancers are Nataliana de Sousa and Galeris Mavis.
Thank you.
a beautiful song, and as the song says, we're grateful for each and every one of you. So we have a number of special presentations tonight, and of course we're looking forward to hearing tonight's word of gratitude, but all of that is coming up in approximately 30 minutes. In the meantime, stick around, and please enjoy dinner. Don't go anywhere. Enjoy the meal because it is very delicious. So, bon appetit. How was dinner? I hope everyone is enjoying dinner. How was the chicken? Delicious, right? All right, so let's continue with our agenda for tonight. I want to inform you that the silent auction has been closed already, just so you guys know. So I repeat, the silent auction is closed. Right now, we're going to go ahead and see a video presentation by the Lee Health Video Service.
National Association is a program that for 43 years we've been in the community, helping people in different areas, helping people in education, helping people in trying to do good for themselves.
They help the youth in our community and do youth programs. They give food, they give clothing. They're anything that anyone could need. You can come to the Nations and they will help you.
Suarez first came to Fort Myers, and I would see him driving around town in a blue truck, making sure that anybody who needed anything had what they needed. There was furniture, and then there came food and medicine. So my heart has been with Nations for a very long time. I've been blessed to be able to say that Dr. Suarez is my father, and he ingrained in me that we are to help people. So as a child, I've always been able to watch my father and help individuals, which has really helped me and developed me of who I am today.
Not only did I become a volunteer, but Nations Association also helped me when I first got here as a single parent.
Individuals during Thanksgiving that they didn't have money for a simple turkey, but were able to come together as a community and give them a turkey and give them groceries so that their Thanksgiving can also be as happy as others are.
One of the things that's real important to us are the health fairs that take place there. And we have been participating in those since the very beginning. And it's a great way for us to get into the community and to share the health benefits of screenings and all the things we can do to improve the health of that community.
They help migrants go through the transition of coming here into this county, whether it's with the food, whether it's with employment. They've done a lot of job development. I've known of clients that they've helped obtain different type of positions that they've needed to move forward.
Reverend Suarez has been a leader in Fort Myers for 30 years, and Lee Health has been proud to be a partner with him in all the work that he's doing. He really is a tremendous human who cares deeply about his community, his friends, and those that need help the most. And we're proud to stand with him in all the work that he's doing to support our community.
He is indeed a force of nature. He does love this community. Reverend Suarez loves everyone. His heart is golden, it's pure, and he does so very much for so many.
I just personally want to add a note of thanks to Reverend Suarez for his years of service to this community and to the lives he's touched through the educational programs, the health fairs, etc. He truly has changed the face of this community.
I love Reverend Suarez, and his wife behind every good man is a great woman, and that Ruthie is a wonderful part, and all his children, because it is a family. It's a family organization.
I am absolutely grateful and thankful of all the sponsors that for years have helped the Nation Association. I am thankful for the volunteers that have taken the opportunity to take from their time to participate and directly impact the nation so that we can help others. And I'm very thankful to my dad that has always been there for the community, the passion that he's had, and he has allowed me to be who I am today. He's enabled me, he's inspired me, and he is truly my hero.
The unity of the Suarez family, and of course, the support of our sponsors. Now let's go ahead and continue with some words of gratitude. So I'm going to go ahead and call Mayor Kevin Anderson, Fort Myers City Mayor.
Thank you. It's truly an honor to represent the people of the city of Fort Myers. And it's an honor tonight to stand here and represent my colleagues on the city council and give in a few words of gratitude for Reverend Suarez. And before I get going, I just want to acknowledge that Dr. Lynn Beauchette, the council person from Ward 4, is present with us here tonight as well. For over 40 years, Reverend Suarez has risen each morning with a single goal in mind, and that is to provide those in need with hope and a helping hand. In addition to running the Nation's Association and providing the less fortunate with food, furniture, clothing, and scholarships to help students escape poverty, he has also served as a member of the Fort Myers Housing Authority and a chaplain with the Fort Myers Police Department. When I worked at Chico's, it was one of my pleasures to coordinate with Reverend Suarez to do the Thanksgiving turkey drive. We did that for several years. And while Israel has led a very productive, interesting, and challenging life, it hasn't always been easy. As we know, he grew up one of nine children in one of the toughest neighborhoods in Brooklyn, New York. And even here in Southwest Florida, he's faced some real challenges. He faced an armed assailant one time. He survived a heart attack. And most recently, he survived COVID. What a guy. It is an honor to know Reverend Suarez, and I'm proud to call him friend. Ruth, thank you so much for sharing him with us all these years. May God bless you with many, many years, Reverend Suarez. Thank you.
Beautiful words. Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and for sharing with us. Now, before I call the next speaker, I'm going to tell you a little bit about her. Her name is Janelle Perez. She is a 2006 scholar. She was awarded at the Edison State College scholarship. She later continued her education at Florida Gulf Coast University, earning her bachelor's in psychology. She also has a master's in clinical mental health counseling at Hodges University. She is now employed through Lee Health and works as the first ever behavioral health specialist for the outpatient pediatric behavioral health department. So please, Janelis Ramos Perez, you can join me.
Thank you, Miriam, for that introduction. Good evening, friends, colleagues, and neighbors. Once upon a time, Dr. Israel Suarez had an idea. In 2006, I'm sorry, this idea was to figure out a way to change lives in Southwest Florida. In 2006, I participated in the nation's youth program and was the recipient of a scholarship at Florida Southwestern State College. If you had asked me what I was grateful for back then, my immediate response might have been to say the scholarship, the youth gala, the program, all of which were very meaningful to me. However, now as an adult, I am better able to define my gratitude to the things that have impacted my life since the night I received the award. To begin with, I am grateful for the demonstration of a spirit of service, to see an example of what serving with passion looks like. For example, seeing firsthand through the years the turkey and Christmas drives, the development of the youth program, and how this association has assisted families in their times of most need. I personally have applied the same spirit of service to volunteering for organizations like Valerie's House, who works with children who have lost a loved one, also by interning for Hope Hospice with the same team that helped my family through the process when my mother was battling cancer, and later the bereavement process. And further, by developing my own passion for helping those with mental health needs by interning for the Children's Advocacy Center, and currently through the work I am privileged to do with Lee Health. Furthermore, I am grateful to you, Dr. Suarez, for demonstrating the power of a connection. The scholarship I earned in 2006 to Florida Southwestern College allowed me to build a connection with the college's student support service team. This team works with first-generation college students and were fundamental to my success at that point in my college education. The FSW team connected me to the FGCU team, who were also an essential part of my journey towards earning my master's in psychology. Having made lifelong connections in these institutions, I was motivated to further my education and join the clinical mental health counseling program at Hodges University, from which I graduated in 2020. These connections have taught me the value of having someone who is ahead of you in the path of success. Someone who is willing to be present with you in your current place, and the power of helping others who are behind you. These connections have not only been present in my scholar career, but also in the workforce. My first job was with Palm Printing, who was a sponsor of Nations, and in 2006 offered me an opportunity to work as part of their team. There have been so many along the way. Marion Garcia Esquire and Hamilton Law Firm were also sponsors that offered myself and other scholars employment opportunities. Talking about the power of a connection, it was when I let the Hamiltons know that I had changed my interest from law to psychology that they connected me with the Silver Psychology Center. A few years later, one of the psychologists I worked with at the center learned about my interest in organizational and developmental psychology and referred me to the Pediatric Neurology, Developmental, and Behavioral Health Department with Lee Health. I currently serve as the first ever behavioral health specialist in this department. I also had the unique ability to be a part of the development of the role and the process of implementing procedures in order to best serve children in crisis through their mental health journey, something I simply do not take for granted. Other scholars have also accomplished remarkable things. Trini Soto, also a 2006 scholar, is a civil business litigation attorney here in Fort Myers. Gladys Hernandez is now the owner of Peace of Life Boutique. Catherine Pinedo, a social marketing associate for Target. And Suhailis Cantillon, a registered nurse at Cape Coral Hospital, who served our families selflessly, working in the COVID-19 unit through the worst of the pandemic. Last but not least, I am grateful for the inspiration to lead. Dr. Suarez and Nation Association has led by example, promoting good in our community. They have inspired me to lead with courage and have a vision for possibilities that have not yet been accomplished in Southwest Florida. I am inspired by the evidence that investing time and effort into our community will make a difference. I conclude today with the hope that I have been able to express my gratitude for the impact this organization has had in my life. Thank you for demonstrating a spirit of service, the power of a connection, and inspiring others to lead with courage. My most sincere and heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Suarez, the man with a great idea, his family, Nation's board and staff, sponsors, and all of the community members that have in some way contributed. My name is Janelis Perez, and I am proud to be a part of Nation's legacy. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Janelis, for sharing your journey and how Nations has impacted your life. Now, before I call the next two remarkable men and leaders in our community, we're going to talk about Nations' 43 years of service, the past and present. I'm going to tell you a little bit about them. So starting with Dr. John D. Meyer, he was named the fifth president of Hodges University in December 2017. In his more than 20 years of public and private education experience, he has served as a professor, chair, dean, and an executive vice president of academic affairs. He also formed an alliance with Goodwill of Southwest Florida to further increase accessibility of workforce training opportunities by bringing instruction into the communities. The first three sites located within Goodwill stores in Bonita Springs, Lehigh Acres, and Port Charlotte have opened to offer classes and workshops and provide workers with the skills and knowledge needed for their career goals. He is also a two-time graduate of Hodges University, earning his Master's in Business Administration and Bachelor of Science in Accounting. Now, also Dr. Michael Martin. He is president of Florida Gulf Coast University. The Florida Gulf Coast University Board of Trustees unanimously selected Dr. Martin to become the institution's fourth president on July 1st, 2017. Also, Mr. Martin came to FGCU from the Colorado State University system. He is a native of Crosby, Minnesota, earning a bachelor's degree in business and economics and a master's degree in economics as well. And his membership on local, state, and national boards and organizations spans decades of service and has included the Farm Foundation Board of Trustees and the International Agricultural Trade Research Consortium. So both of you, Dr. John Meyer and Dr. Mike Martin, if you could please join me.
I'm up first, John, if you wish.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, John. It's a delight to be here. It's a delight to be here with my friend and colleague, John Meyer, who is, along with a number of people in this room, transforming the community continually. It's a real honor to have a few moments to speak about Israel Suarez. And I know he's Dr. Suarez, he's Reverend Suarez, but since we're about the same age, I'm simply to refer to him as Israel, because he is a friend as well as a colleague. I've been here about 4.5 years, and when I arrived, I was given a list of names of people that I was instructed to get to know. Quite a very long list. And the definition of who was on that list, is that my pacemaker, correct? I know. The definition of people on that list were the people who were having a profound impact on the community. And it was instructive to me to be instructed to learn what they were up to. High on that list is Israel Suarez. So I came to know him very early in my time here. And the time I've been here, I've had the opportunity to get to know him better, but as well to observe what he has done and how he's done it. 1978, the birth of Nations Association, has another interesting meaning for me. In 1978, a man named James McGregor Burns, a scholar on leadership, published the most widely used leadership book ever published, called Leadership. Bestseller, and still is used across the country in leadership courses and leadership studies. And Burns defined two kinds of leaders: transactional leaders, the people who get up every day and make things happen as they should. It's important to have transactional leaders. That's how you make a community work on a day-to-day basis. And then transformational leaders. And they're the ones who, through their leadership skills, fundamentally change their community, the society, and individual lives. And when you think about, and when I think about Israel Suarez, I think about a true transformational leader in the context that Burns meant it. And occasionally I reflect on others that I think fit that category, and some of them are more contemporary and some of them are back in time, right? We lost John Lewis not long ago. We just lost Colin Powell, Cesar Chavez, Russell Banks, who led the American Indian Movement, Jack Briggs, Dolores Huerta. You go down the list and you can see the kind of character they brought and the kind of impact they had, sometimes in very large and dramatic ways, and sometimes in smaller ways. But the incremental impact of transformational leaders can over time be seen unambiguously. And what I have observed both in the history of the Nation Association and in the day-to-day comportment and commitment of Israel Suarez, unambiguously, as I suggest, meets that definition. And what's interesting for me about getting to know Reverend Suarez is it's not just about Nations Association. That's clearly the commitment of his life, and it's clearly the institution that has continued to carry on his mission. But if you think about his impact, there are many other ways it happens. One is he's a role model, and he's even a role model for many of us who are his contemporaries. To say, I learned something today from Israel that I ought not forget about the way to go about participating in a community. His pure energy, and as already suggested, he's managed to beat back many challenges, physical and otherwise, to build an organization which is run because other people are willing to invest in it. And I told him one day that we share the philosophy about philanthropy in this community. Winners bet on winners. People who are capable of supporting bet because they believe they're buying into a winner. And Nation Association would not be successful if he had not made it a winner in the minds of winners. There's no question that he inspires people by his comportment and by his just the honest way he goes about carrying on life every day. We had a conversation not long ago, just after he was coming off of COVID. And you can see both the challenge version we showed you in the process. And that is a role model for anyone who stops to observe it. And then finally, there are just those characteristics that you always find interesting in people, right? Optimism, I think the dove thing is part of it, right? Optimism, determination, persistence, commitment, compassion. And one of the things that I observe about him all the time that I find a fascinating reality, and it's this reality. You can be tough without having to be mean. You can be tough in what you do. You can be tough in taking on challenges. Too many people, I think right today, in this instability we are living through, have missed the notion that tough and mean aren't the same thing. So Israel has demonstrated to many of us a toughness in getting things done, and at the same time being a gentle soul who gets it done. And if we don't teach our children anything else, for me, that's an enormous lesson. And then finally, I'll just say, and it's already been well demonstrated in the video, the Nation Association is a remarkable organization. It takes on the challenges that others have not. It gets people's lives turned in ways they might not ever have other been turned. We will never know all of the impacts, because we won't know what would have happened had it not been here. But I think it's safe to say that there are people who might have otherwise ended up in prison, or otherwise ended up in a dead-end job, or in one way or another ended up in a state of life that they did not prefer, that didn't have that happen because of the intervention of the Nation Association. So for all those reasons, I'm delighted to be here with my colleague, and I'm particularly delighted to say yet again, happy birthday to the Nation Association. And I thought about this, Israel, as I was walking in, I was doing the math in my head, and I was thinking, well, what if I said 43 more, Israel? And I know how old he is. And I said, damn, if anyone can pull it off, it's Israel. So thank you very much. Congratulations, my friend.
Thanks, Mike. I was going to give you a cheap shot, but I'm not going to do that. You'll stay on the stage.
I will go right here. I'll stand right here.
I have a job for you. I'm going to put you to work here in a few minutes.
I got it.
If you're trustworthy.
I can handle it.
Just checking. So, good evening. Similar to Dr. Martin's experience, I had a very similar experience when I first met Reverend Suarez myself. I was at Hodges University, newly back to Hodges University. The then president of Hodges University says, you have to meet this guy. Okay, so I went in, and do you remember, we were in the little conference room in H151, and that's where I met and was introduced to, and had the first opportunity to observe, sort of in his natural state and in the way that he does things, Reverend Suarez. And I don't think I'm being mean when I say that this is a gentleman who is he's a giant among men, but he's not a giant among men, if you know what I mean. And even at that, I found his stature and his presence to be compelling and overwhelming. And much like Mike, being an academic, you know, Mike talked about the transformational and transactional leadership, and I wasn't at all offended when he left me off the list of transformational leadership. I didn't make the transactional list either, which that's sort of a lesson. But I was also struck by this presence. And I thought, how do I get my arms around this? And I learned a little bit more. I went to Nations Association and I learned a little bit more about the organization, what it does, and how it does it, more importantly, who it is behind those things. And I have a little different take. I agree 100%, transactional and transformational. Transformational certainly sums it up. But what struck me is that the organization that Reverend Suarez runs lean. So if you are ever studied, took any business classes, you doubtless heard about lean organizations. And I took the liberty of having a list here, but comprises a lean organization. Tell me if I get this right. So people who run lean organizations create a big value out of small resources. Big value out of small resources. They are focused. They are aligned. They are humble. They are collaborative. They are engaged. They are resilient. They are grateful. They are efficient. But most of all, they're tenacious. And it was that last adjective that struck me. Tenacity. I think Dr. Suarez personifies tenacity. And everything the Nations Association does personifies tenacity. So on that point, let me share two very quick stories. One of them, I won't tell it in its entirety because I would wager, let me do it this way. I'm sorry, I'm a professor at Harvard, I can't help it. Let me see a show of hands. Who's heard the Air Force One story? Wow, are you kidding? One hand over, you get an A, sir. One hand. So I don't know the whole story because I wasn't there, but I'll give you the Cliff Notes version. Tell me if I get it wrong, Dr. Schwartz. Air Force One has George Bush on it, flies into the airport in Sarasota County, and Dr. Suarez and Nations Association are going to be named the let me get it right, 276th point of light. So you'll remember the points of light. And I guess Dr. Suarez was smitten, taken with the airplane, thought it might be cool, to have a look and see what all's in there. This is the laboratory, the same, and this type of stuff. So he marches onto the tarmac and strolls deliberately, purposefully, tenaciously towards Air Force One. Gets to the stairs, gets intercepted by the Secret Service. The Secret Service are about ready to put him in handcuffs and cart him away. Here comes the President, President Bush, saying, "That's all good." Takes him on Air Force One, gives him the tour. There's not another person in this room that would have pulled that off. That's kind of a humorous story. Here's one that's a little more focused and a little more to the point, and honestly, much more recent. When COVID-19 had first reared its ugly head and was creating the havoc that we now know that it had created, after the worst of it, but still well into its throes, we were meeting one day, and Dr. Swarer said to me, you know, we've got to figure this out. We've got to get information into the hands of the pastors in the Hispanic community so that they in turn can get it into the heads and the hearts and the minds of people that they serve. And this was his idea. So he came to me and said, do you think we could host an event at Hodges University where and we could provide some education on some of the basic things, prevention and so on, that deal with COVID-19? So naturally I said, sure, why not? I said, who's going to teach it? He goes, we'll get him. So he arranged, true to his word, he arranged for Lee Health to provide the technical expertise. We got the health department. So he has this ability to float an idea to somebody, and with a sentence or two, and without even a specific ask, get it to happen. And so lo and behold, we filled our big multi-purpose room with, about 150 or more pastors from all over the region to come and be educated about how to teach their flocks about COVID-19 and prevention measures for it. It was a great humanitarian thing and a big success all the way around. So with that, as an example, what I would like to do, Mike did say earlier that he was trustworthy. So what I'm going to do, if you're prepared to do this, sir, is I'm going to deputize you. What do you want? Can I deputize you as a provost?
Sure.
Okay.
It's a good point. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Sure, no problem. One day you can return the favor. But for tonight, I'm going to deputize Dr. Martin. And it's important for you to recognize that he is the president of FGCU, which is a little school somewhere in Southwest Florida. We are, of course, Hodges University. Everyone should have got a much larger school. We have the best graduates. That's right. So I'm going to deputize him as the provost, and we are going to reenact a little ceremony that we conducted at our commencement exercises this past June. We, of course, were not able to have the commencement exercises the year before because of COVID. This last June we had them live, but we did two graduating classes together, and as part of that, we awarded a doctorate of humane letters to Reverend Suarez. This is kind of a big deal, so we would like to reenact it tonight. So, Reverend, would you join us here on stage, please? Well, and it's awarded in recognition of selfless, transformational service to humanity. I should point out that Reverend Suarez is in great company with this credential because George H.W. Bush holds one. Actually, he holds four of them, but no one's counting. You've got them. Yeah. Holds four of them, and it's an impressive recognition. So how we teed this up at graduation was the Reverend Israel Suarez founded Nations Association Charities in Fort Myers in 1978 and is this year celebrating his 43rd year serving the community in Fort Myers. In 1990, Nations Association was designated the 276th Point of Light by President George H.W. Bush. Nations Association focuses on that and helps them improve their self-esteem, improve academics, learn life skills, stay away from drugs and crime, and so on. Nations Association Drug Stop is a mentoring program designed to enforce positive lifestyles and affirmations for at-risk middle school and high school students. It addresses community issues and provides education on crime, drug, and suicide prevention and anti-gang and bullying strategies. Reverend Suarez has been extremely successful in these and other community outreach endeavors, and even in his 70s, right? Yeah, he's 70s or maybe 40s, something like that, shows no signs of slowing down or losing his passion. His depth of knowledge, experience, and acceptance in the community are unquestioned. He supports Hodges University in all that we do, especially as the region's first Hispanic-serving institution. So Reverend Suarez, by the authority vested in me, by the faculty and the Board of Trustees of Hodges University, I hereby reconfer upon you the Honorary Doctorate of Humane Letters with all rights and privileges thereunto appertaining. You good? Thank you. I love your outfit. I'm going to have to get one just like it.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Looks like this is my great opportunity. And we spent it for my wife, my three daughters, the co-director of the National Association, people who believe in what we do. It's very important. I've been in the area from 1976 when I arrived from New York City. From that time until now, we've been helping people in different areas. And I'd like to say thank you for those people that trust me in doing my job. I got a blessing that I've been running the National Association for 43 years and without government money. The majority of the agency always appeal to government. I've been getting my economic from different groups because so many I don't want to mention because I don't want to leave anybody out. But there are people who believe in what we do. We lost people, we care for people. And I feel that when you have that in yourself, you got a lot of friends and you got a lot of people that put money to move on. Running an organization is not easy. And getting and doing it without government money is not easy. But God gave me the privilege to do it for the good of those that can do it by themselves. And this event is practically dedicated not to me, dedicated for those who have been helping me to move into doing things in the community. Running the National Association every month is $11,000. And with an increase of so many agencies. When I started, there was Rescue Mission, Goodwill, and myself. 1976. Now we have so many agencies that depending in the community or the city and the county, and getting $11,000 every month is rough, but we have the glory, you know. I'm here doing what I gotta do in the name of the kingdom. So I want to say you thank you for each one of you, the agency, that institution who believe and trust in what I do. So at this point, I feel good that you will be able to be here to help me to move on. And to, I don't know, only God now, because we're doing it in God time. So thank you for your respect. Thank you for your care. Thank you for everything that I've been doing it for the last 43 years. I'm 77 years old, and I look good. And I go there, and I got a contract. I'm gonna retire when I'll be 100 years. So that's my goal. for gratitude, I'm gonna finish with a prayer. And I feel that each one of you gonna donate me $1,000. And gonna help me to get that $11,000 in the morning. If you decide not doing it, that's all right. I've been doing it, right? I've been doing it. You don't know when more, but God is always in charge. I'm gonna give you a gift, I'm gonna give you a prayer. You can stay right there. Father God, we love you. Because you are so good. Because without you, no way we could do it. In my 43 years, you've been next to me and my family and the board. And I want to say thank you that you give me the strength and you give me the power to do what I gotta do. For the good of those that can do it by itself. Thank you for the company and for the program that been helping me. I recognize for God that when you help those that in the good to do thing, and thank you for this event, and I ask you that you can bless each one of us when we go home, and we do this prayer in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
I know this has been a very special night for you, emotional night, and Dr. Swadis and his family, I know you have been through rough times battling COVID-19, but he recovered, and what astonished me is that as soon as he recovered, he went straight to his office and kept working for our community. So thank you again, Dr. Suarez, for everything you do year after year to make Southwest Florida a better place to live. So this has been a very special night for all of us. Unfortunately, it is coming to an end. And before that, I want to remind you guys that the auction is closed. So the silent auction winner, the lucky winner, if you could please redeem your item tickets at the auction area in the foyers. Also, some of the sponsors are going to receive the centerpieces, so I'm going to mention them right now. Shady Rest Foundation, Sanibel Community Church, Lee Health, Fort Myers Memorial Gardens, Florida Gulf Coast University, Lee County Sheriff's Office, City of Fort Myers Police, the Housing Authority of the City of Fort Myers, Great Florida Insurance, the School District of Lee County, and of course, Ruth Suarez. And the centerpieces are by committee member Denise Fernandez and from the committee. So you can go ahead and choose the centerpiece from the tables. And for us ladies, we're gonna go ahead and receive a cream from La Bible, La Biblia Godly Mumio Skincare. This is only for us ladies, the lucky girl. And yeah, if there's more, maybe the guys can get some of these creams. So again, thank you very much to each and every one of you for joining us tonight. It's been a pleasure for me as well joining you. Thank you for having me, and thank you for being here at our 43rd Nations Gratitude Banquet. So drive carefully, good night, and God bless.